The Poppy Story. The First World War, or the Great War, started in 1914. The British Empire and their allies, France, Russia, Italy, and America, fought a war against Germany, Austria-Hungary, and the Ottoman Empire. Millions of men joined the British armed forces and went to fight in the war. The conditions were terrible, and millions were killed or injured. Those that did return home would never be the same again. One of the largest battles of the war took place around the town of Ypres in the Flanders region of Belgium. While serving in Flanders, a young Canadian soldier called John McCree noticed how bright red poppies grew wild amid the war-torn landscape. Despite the devastation that surrounded him, he was inspired by the poppies that grew there to write the poem In Flanders Fields. His poem became very popular, and the bright red poppy would soon be adopted as a symbol to remember all those who'd fought in the war. The First World War ended at 11 o'clock in the morning on the 11th of November, 1918. This was the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month. The war had lasted over 4 years. The 11th of November every year is called Remembrance Day or Armistice Day. After the war ended, people started making paper poppies to sell. They sold poppies to raise money to help the millions of sailors, soldiers, and airmen who were coming home from the war. These people are called ex-servicemen and women, or veterans. On Remembrance Day, people wear a poppy, and at 11 o'clock in the morning, the same time the war officially ended in 1918, there is a 2-minute silence. This is for people to remember all the veterans who have served their country in a war. Not just the First World War. Remembrance Day happens every year around the world. The poppy isn't the same everywhere. Some countries use different designs for their poppy. In England, Wales, and Northern Ireland, the poppy has 2 petals and a leaf. But in Scotland, the poppy has 4 petals and no leaf. All the poppies sold in Scotland are made in the Lady Hague's Poppy Factory in Edinburgh. The factory was founded in 1926 by Lady Hague, the wife of Field Marshal Douglas Hague, who was the commander of the British Army in France during the First World War. When the factory first opened, all the poppies were handmade by just 2 ex-servicemen with some red paper and a pair of scissors. Today, there are over 40 ex-servicemen with disabilities who work in the factory. These men make 5 million poppies every year for the Scottish Poppy Appeal. They also make more than 10,000 wreaths and tens of thousands of wooden remembrance symbols. These include Christian crosses, Muslim crescents, Sikh candas, the Jewish Star of David, and a symbol for humanists. All the poppies are still made by hand, although a machine now cuts out the poppy shape. The ex-servicemen make 2 types of poppy. A poppy with a green plastic stem, and a stick-on poppy. When all the poppies have been made, they're packaged up with collecting tins for the money, then sent to our volunteers all over Scotland. Every village, town and city in Scotland has volunteers who donate their time for free to sell poppies in their local area. Poppies are sold in lots of places. You can find them in shops, supermarkets, offices, schools, factories, churches, and hospitals. Volunteers collect the money made from selling poppies. They also hold fundraising events like jumble sales, cake sales, and races to raise even more money. Thanks to their hard work, our volunteers raise millions of pounds from the people of Scotland every year. All the money that's made helps ex-servicemen and women in need after serving in the Navy, Army, or Air Force. We also help their families, their wives, husbands, partners, and children. We help with house repairs, wheelchairs and specially adapted vehicles to help them live in their own homes for longer. We also give money so they can retrain, start their own businesses or grow an existing business. And we give advice, information and support to deal with any problems that may be encountered along the way, helping them rebuild their lives. All this from a tiny poppy.